Hey guys, it's Erica and thank you so much for watching this video today. Today we are finally gonna do my Black Friday Cyber Monday haul. I have been wanting to do this video for so many days, but one, it has taken a lot of these things several days to come in and I am still waiting on, I think, one item. So I figured, heck, it's close enough. I have been very busy here lately, so this is really both my first opportunity to sit down and do this video. Okay, yesterday I was lazy. I could have done it, but I just needed a day to rest up, honey. But basically now is the best time for me to be doing this video. So let's jump right in. I didn't mean to buy this much stuff. I feel like there's a hair in my face. What you need to keep in mind is, honey, my birthday is December 7th, Pearl Harbor Day, the date that will live in infamy. So when David asked me what I wanted for my birthday, I said, really, in the event that I get this job that I've applied for, still not heard anything, honey, I need some new, like, work-appropriate clothing. And even if I don't get the job, you know, this is going to be stuff I can wear out to eat, to church, things like that. I just needed some good kind of staple pieces in my closet. So that is why I got a lot of these clothes, but I did get a few beauty things. I kind of feel like that's probably where we should start because that's where most people are interested. Let's start with Ulta, honey. So let me go ahead and get this out of the way. This was like a gift with purchase either on Black Friday or Cyber Monday. I don't remember which one. I can't remember which one for any of these, okay? But it was sometime during that time period, all right? And I think this makeup bag is just beautiful. This was a gift with purchase, and it came cram-packed full with all this stuff. I see somebody outside walking at my house, honey. Got a Urban Decay Vice liquid lipstick in Big Bang. This is beautiful. I've not even had a chance to look at this yet. I've tried to leave as much as I can of this stuff, like, in the package. That way, I didn't lose it. Have a Saint-Tropez One Night Only Gloss. This is for your body, honey. Like a body gloss. Shimmer that decollete up. I will. Murad, got some moisturizer. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff in here. Lipstick Queen, lip liner. What we got here, honey? Macadamia Ultra Rich Moisture Cleansing Conditioner. Mm-hmm. All kinds of stuff. What's this? The Body Shop Oils of Life. I mean, there's so much in here. So, I'm not going to bore you with all that, but definitely some really nice, good-sized items in that. So, I don't know if you watch my vlogs, but I have mentioned in several of them that I have been re-watching the show Weeds. Have y'all ever watched this? It's not typically the kind of show that I would watch. The lead character is like a drug dealer. She sells marijuana, but it's Mary Louise Parker. It is a little bit raunchy, like kind of like Sopranos, something like that. So, if that's not your thing, don't watch it. But if it is, you know, if you ain't offended by cussing and whatever, then I highly recommend watching that show, which is on Netflix. The thing that I took away from watching it this time, Mary Louise Parker is a beautiful woman. Her makeup in this show is so pretty. It's very, very minimal. It looks as though she probably only has on foundation, mascara, maybe like a lip balm, and then this beautiful bright blush. I mean, I love it. And she definitely wears her blush more like I do. I like it kind of high up on the cheek under the eye. I think that's just a very pretty look. Like, say, instead of doing it, a lot of people do their blush back here or even like down here. Like, no, honey, pop it right under the eye. And it's a very youthful, fresh look, I think. But anyways, her blush is just so pretty and bright. I love bright blush, honey. Put on, the more the merrier, clown cheeks all the way. That's my favorite kind of look. So, I have been researching what blush she wore back then. And I found some interviews of, like, the makeup artist from the show and also from her around that time. And I did find out what she wore. One was the Tarte Cheek Stain in Flush. I just now took the plastic wrap off that. I can't wait to use it. I've not opened this one up. But honey, I already dipped into the Posy Tint by Benefit and also Benefit Dandelion. I used to own Dandelion way back in the day. And guys, it did not show up on me at all. But I think it has since been reformulated. This is the small one. I got the small Posy Tint and small Dandelion just to see if I really would like them. Because I'm skeptical about Dandelion. But I have to say, this is the blush that I'm wearing today. Beautiful, bright, and so much like her character on the show. So definitely home run win for these two. I put this on first, and I top it with a little bit of this. It's gorgeous. It's so incredibly gorgeous. Now, I'm pretty sure this came from Ulta too. This is the holiday limited edition set of the NARS Velvet Lip Glides. I love the NARS Velvet Lip Glides. Honey, I bought this same set last year, but the colors were all a little bit darker. This year, they're a little bit brighter. I especially look forward to trying this color right here. Let me pop it out and show it to you, honey. It is Immoral. Just a pretty, really bright kind of fuchsia. These stay on your lips so well. It's kind of like a liquid lipstick, but it doesn't have that fully dry down matte like layer of plastic on your lips. I don't like liquid lipsticks. Y'all know that, honey. I'm a traditional lipstick straight out the bullet kind of girl. But that being said, these are extremely long wearing. They feel so nice on the lips and they wear off evenly. You don't have that like weird ring around your lips whenever they decide to start wearing off. So excited to have these, and I've not been using them because I wanted to show them to you. So now I can finally unbox them, honey, and put them in here in my drawer with those from last year. So if you spent so much from NARS, you got a couple of free gifts, and I got the NARS Pore and Shine Control Primer. This is right up my alley. I mean, I have huge pores and I have oily skin, so I can't wait to use this. Again, been saving all this stuff. And then I also got a free Velvet Lip Glide from NARS. This is like a little bitty baby one, but it's in the shade La Palace. And I think this is one of their permanent colors. I'm not for sure if these are all permanent or limited. That is Piper down there digging around, but just a beautiful kind of brick red. So definitely looking forward to trying that. And then just some samples. I'm pretty sure that's all I got from Ulta. Let's move on to Nordstrom. So we will do the beauty stuff from Nordstrom first. Here's my little bag of samples, honey. Got some Replica perfume. Looks like a MAC mascara, maybe. And then some Kiehl's Daily Reviving Concentrate. Okay. The lipstick that I'm wearing, I've worn this so many times since I got it. And guys, it is the limited edition Chanel Rouge Allure La Rouge Intense Luminous Intense Lip Color in number 4. I don't know if the color is limited edition or if it was just this red packaging, because I know the packaging was limited. But guys, I'm not someone who just splurges on really, really high-end lipsticks. I'm talking like your Tom Ford, Chanel, things like that. You know, I do have high-end lipsticks, but it's rare that I buy one that expensive. If you're ever going to do it during the holidays and get you like a gorgeous bright red lipstick. It is the one I'm wearing today. It's bright. It's beautiful. Even though they call it luminous, it's not very luminous. Like, and it gets fairly matte the longer that you wear it. It stays on like a boss. I'm not even lying. So highly recommend, go get you a Chanel red lipstick for the holidays. You won't be sorry that you did. And then the only other beauty item that I did purchase was the Bobbi Brown Caviar and Rubies eyeshadow palette. Did y'all see this on Nordstrom's site? It looks beautiful. I have been waiting to use it till I did this video. These days in my makeup collection, it is more about quality versus quantity. I'm not just buying every palette that hits the shelf, honey. I'm being selective about it. Look at this beautiful palette. Hopefully the colors are showing. So this palette has 9 colors, a mixture of mattes and metallics, and then right in the middle, that's called Gilded. It's called a Diamond Dust eyeshadow. This one right here, okay? And so what really intrigued me with this palette was this one down here in Deep Sapphire. I love navy eyeshadows. Look at that. And then I also am really into this Black Plum. The look of it. I mean, I've not used this yet, but it's beautiful, guys. I love Bobbi Brown products. Can't wait. We gotta get something to wipe this off with, honey. This was $75. And this was not on sale on Black Friday or Cyber Monday or whatever. But if you spent so much from Bobbi Brown, you got a free brush. What are you called? I don't know. I think it's just an angled eyeliner brush. But this is like a $25, $30 brush on the Nordstrom site. Honey, you got it for free. So there's that. Hopefully you can see it. Okay. You also got a, I don't know if you can see it, it's a Cyber 5 on the back. A Longwear Cream Eyeshadow Stick. A bronzing powder in medium 2. So there's the bronzing powder. Really good size. Little travel thing of that. The eyeshadow stick is in golden pink. Then you also got this little bag of goodies. If you spent so much from Bobbi Brown. And Bobbi Brown stuff is expensive if you buy it. I got the Extra Eye Repair Cream. This is a very thick eye cream. I do have some of that downstairs. I got an Instant Full Cover Concealer in the shade Sand. Lots of free gifts with the Bobbi Brown stuff. So there's the concealer. So cute. Never used that before. Got a Bobbi Brown lip color in the shade Sand Wash Pink. So really, really cute. Good size little sample of that. And then I got the Vitamin Enriched Face Base. And a very good little pot of that. Okay. So that is all of the beauty stuff that I got from Nordstrom. I did get a few kind of fashion-y items. I did order some stuff on the Hope Look app. And you know, if you have the Hope Look app, then you know, like, Nordstrom Rack is also kind of included in there. So I'm not for sure if this was Nordstrom Rack or Hope Look, but it's just a really pretty kind of holiday red scarf. And I have been wearing the fire out of it because it's just, I love a kind of rayon material for my scarves. So definitely been wearing that. These were from just Nordstrom, honey. I got me a new pair of Ray-Bans because aviators are always in style, right? And I love blue lenses. I love the gold frame, and I love how these are like kind of large. These are just so pretty. And I don't know if you all have paid attention to any of my social media. I'm very, very allergic to costume jewelry these days. Not really on my wrist. Like, these are bourbon and bow ties, and that doesn't bother me. My watch doesn't bother me, nothing like that. It's my neck, and mainly like costume necklaces or big hoop earrings or any kind of earrings that dangle down and touch my neck. I'm reacting very strongly. So I'm getting rid of it all of my costume necklaces and earrings. I have the gold balls that I wear in my ear are real, but they're big. And I had a pair of earrings from Target. I don't know if y'all even remember seeing these like several videos back, but it was like a hook and it went through, and then there were just two little like dangly gold strings that hung down. Very delicate, very simple. Those I wore on Thanksgiving, and I broke out so bad. So as soon as I came home that night, like, I took them out of my ears and threw them in the garbage because it was so painful. And I actually found those either on Hope Look or Nordstrom Rack. I'm not for sure, but those have not arrived yet. Hope Look takes forever to ship sometimes, right? So it's probably Hope Look. I'll put a picture of those here. And they were roughly like $40 or $50 for the real gold ones of those. But I wanted just a really delicate little ball to pair with those, because I figured the ones that I have would be a little overpowering for the delicate earring that I ordered. So I also got these, and they are just a 14 karat ball. And they're very, very small. These were very inexpensive. I want to say like $15, $20 maybe. But just 14 karat solid gold studs. I'm just going to set everything to the side. So moving on to American Eagle. I wasn't for sure what kind of khakis I wanted to order in case I do get my new job. So I ordered from three different stores, okay? The first pair that I got were from American Eagle. These are the Artist Flare Chino. And I do have to say, even though they do have like quite a bit of a flare at the bottom, These probably fit me the best out of all of the brands that I've got. They are more short-waisted, which is good for me because I am short-waisted, and they're good and long, and they fit well. So I really do like the Artist Flare Chino. I can't remember the prices on any of this stuff, but it was definitely way marked down on that day. This was on Cyber Monday, I'm pretty sure. And they just had this really pretty kind of holiday red beanie that I thought looked so cute for like the holidays. It's a different color red than the scarf from Nordstrom. I didn't get them to go together. I just got them because they were cute. And this one is different because it actually has a snap. So if you didn't want the big palm, you wouldn't have to wear the big palm, but I'm a big palm kind of gal. And oh, I just think it's so cute. So that's all I got from American Eagle, because it was mainly just about trying to find some pants for work. The next spot that I went to was J. Crew. J. Crew tends to be like, when I need a staple in my closet, like a cashmere sweater vest or chinos or a pea coat, like, J. Crew is where I go. I think I have fuzz on my face from that beanie. I think this was actually from the factory site. And it's just really pretty and feminine. I love the detailing. It kind of looks like pearls whenever you have this sweater on. But just really pretty, basic, would look really nice for an office environment. And then I got a pair of their, what are they called? I don't think it says on here. These are more, instead of like, how the American Eagle ones are like a chino version of a jean. That's basically how they fit. These feel more dressy. These are more like a slack, I guess, because they have like the fancier kind of clasp at the waist, and the pockets are more silky. It's more of a dressier pant, I guess. But I definitely like these almost as much as I like the American Eagle ones. I really do think the American Eagle ones just fit me the best. I think for both of those items from J. Crew on that day, on Cyber Monday, I think it was like $40 for both. So definitely really, really marked down. The next thing is this sweater that I've already been wearing. And if y'all watched my vlog from when I was with my friend Kristen, hi Kristen, from here on YouTube, Kristen Game, this is the sweater that I wore the day that we were together. And it's just so cute. It is from Mod Cloth, and it has these adorable mitten pockets on the belly. And when I first looked at it, I figured like the thumb was like sewn shut. No, the thumb is functional. So I think that is just so cute. I will insert a picture of me wearing this here so that you can see it like on. I paired it with this little skirt from Forever 21. And this was actually sold out in an extra large. And so I could either get a large or a 1X, because that goes, I think, from small to maybe like 3X or something like that. And I got a plain large, and it fits perfect. So the next thing I got was a pair of pajamas from Victoria's Secret. These are made huge, I will say. Victoria's Secret always changes their pajamas every year. If you are like me and you always order them every year, then you know the sizing is always a little inconsistent. Some years they're made huge, some years they're made tiny, and you never know till you're gonna get it. These are fairly new, if I'm not mistaken. I don't think I've ever seen this on there before. These are called the lightweight pajama, I'm pretty sure. And I've always been a fan of the cotton Mayfair pajamas, which is like your standard kind of old man pajamas with the pants and the button-up shirt. But I wanted just a really pretty kind of Christmassy colory print. And these do say, where's the pocket? Dream. If you can see that, the D is colored a little funny, like the round part of the D is lighter. But these are really comfortable. They're just made incredibly, incredibly large. But I mean, it's fine, because when you go to bed, you want to be like comfortable, right? Okay, so this is not new. This is a beanie that I have worn for the last couple of winters. I love it. This is just to give you an idea of how large I like a palm, okay? In case you're wondering, I don't know who this is by. It just says made in Italy. I didn't get this in Italy. I can't remember where I got it, but I don't think I got it while I was in Italy, but okay. I love this pom-pom. Like, that is huge, large, and in charge, okay? There you go. Okay, So that's how big I like a palm. One of my friends had purchased this beanie online. It's a Nike Kentucky beanie, and it didn't have a pom-pom on it. So this is actually a DIY that I did this week. I will link the video down below. But I did my own pom, and it turned out pretty well. What y'all think? But this Nike Kentucky hat, I think it's really cute. I think it would be really cute to wear to a UK game. I would love to do that this winter. But the bargain I did get on Black Friday from, what is that site called? FanOutfitters.com is where I got the Nike and Kentucky beanie. But I think that the pom turned out so well. What do y'all think? And then kind of another UK color themed item that I got was this pair of tennis shoes. I ordered these directly from the Nike website. Whoa. So, you know, Kentucky, we are UK baby. The Kentucky Wildcats, it's kind of a really bright kind of cobalt blue, and it's just kind of hard to find shoes with that color in them, okay? And even though it is the bottom of the shoe, the color does extend up on the toes, and it's right around the bottom, okay, bottom edge. That actually really does show whenever you're wearing these shoes. But I love that they are neutral. They're just really pretty gray with a black swoosh. There's the inside. So the inside looks just like the outside. But I love these guys, and they match all of my UK apparel so well. So let's move on to Old Navy. Old Navy's pants are huge. I got a size 14 in all these, and I bet there was 3 inches on the back of my waist. So I got just a khaki pair of their chinos, and I got them in tall. And what I learned is I don't need a tall in their pants because they are, oh my Lord, I bet the inseam in these is 36 inches, I don't know, long, way too long. So whenever I order the next ones, I will definitely get a regular length. But I have washed these in hot water in the hopes that they would shrink. I've not tried them on since I washed them, but I've got in the basic chino, I got black and khaki. And then I got a pair of their Pixie mid-rise pants. I got these in tall. These lengthwise are okay. And they actually fit me better than the chinos because they're more to your body. But again, they are a little on the big side. So I think that's what I love about Old Navy anyways, honey, is the fact that they are generous with their sizing. Their clothes feel good, honey. I got me a plain basic white button-up from Old Navy, and this is called the Stay White Permanent. I don't know, but it's supposed to like stay white and not yellow. And again, in case I get my job, I figured that would just be a good staple to wear to the office. Yep. They did have a free pair of socks on Cyber Monday, I think. I'm pretty sure this was Cyber Monday. I don't know. But I think so. And I got mine in, what is he, a polar bear? I love fuzzy socks. And the pajamas that I got from them, I love their thermal pajamas. And I actually ordered 3 pieces with this set because these also came with the matching flannel pant. Those were just way too hot. I can't sleep in flannel. Like, I don't do flannel sheets. I don't do flannel pajamas. I don't know why I ordered them, but I have since washed those and give them to my mom, honey, and she loves them. But I did get the thermal pant in the Gingerbread Man, and these do come in tall, thank God. The ones I got last year were not a tall, and they definitely need to be because they're short. But I love this print. See the little gingerbread guy and eggnog, and it's just so cute. And then the matching shirt, of course, says, oh snap. I just got this out of the dryer. But just so incredibly cute. These are definitely my favorite pajamas that I've got this season. The last store that I did order anything from was Bath & Body Works. And on that day, they did have that bag. You know, they always have this bag. It's like $100 and some value, and you get it for $25 when you add it to your cart on that day. And I'm pretty sure that was Cyber Monday, am I right? So I did get that bag full of goodies. The candle that came in that was the champagne toast. It seems like I have ordered this candle in the past and it wasn't as strong. Is it just me? I don't know. It's so good and strong this time. And has it always came with this glitter lid? This is so pretty. Like, I'm gonna set it back there when I'm done with it because it's just so pretty. This time of year, especially, I love foodie scents for my candles, like rich, decadent, like pumpkin, cinnamon, anything kind of yummy like that. That's my favorite kind of candle. The Champagne Toast candle is not floral. It's not food. It's just a sweet, kind of clean scent. And it's a good break from the heavy, decadent scents, like pumpkin pecan waffles or whatever. You know what I'm saying? I've been burning the fire out of this. I mean, yeah, heck, you can already tell. And I flat love that candle this time around. I really, really do. And then two of the things that came in that bag, because I'm not showing what I got as far as gifts on Black Friday and Cyber Monday. This is all just for me, okay? I did take out these two products, okay? And you got the Recharge Sage and Mint Aromatherapy Body Wash and Foam Bath. And you also got the matching body cream. Have you ever smelled the white bottle that you get at Bath & Body Works of the C.O. Bigelow? I'm pretty sure that's who it's by. Men's body wash and shampoo. Like, this smells just like it. When you use this, you smell like a straight up man. In a good way, kind of. But it's a very manly scent. And I just feel very masculine when I wear it. So, I don't know. I have mixed emotions about it. It smells good and I really do like it, but it's definitely manly. And then as far as like just a winter scent to be using, I picked out the coconut mint drop. I don't know if y'all smelled this or not, but I definitely don't get the coconut. I think this smells like mint chocolate chip. That's what it smells like to me. Mint chocolate chip ice cream. And I got the body cream and the shower gel and the body lotion. I do like this scent. It smells good and yummy. I think it just went in my hair. Very mint chocolate chip. There's a slight musk to it. And I'm not crazy about that. Like, I don't like the warm vanilla sugar because it has a musk scent to it. And you definitely get that a little bit with this scent. But it's still yummy and I do like it. And I have been using it, obviously. Oh, and then one more candle. I'm not for certain when I got this. It might have been before Black Friday, but I want to say it was Black Friday. I don't know for sure, but it is the Spice It Up Cinnamon Pretzel Twist candle. Jaclyn Hill had posted about this on her Snapchat, and she said it smelled like Auntie Anne's, you know, the pretzel company in the mall. And I was like, say no more. And honey, it smells just like it. So I definitely love this candle and it's already been burned. I mean, I burn candles every night whenever I'm in the living room. So definitely love this one. So I think that actually does it for my Black Friday and Cyber Monday haul. Other than the earrings that haven't came. But other than that, I'm pretty sure this is it. You know, when all this stuff started coming in, I started wearing it, you know, and I was like, I tried to keep some of it together and then I was like dipping into the box and I can't say for certain that this is everything that I ordered, but it's, for the most part, this is everything that I got. Let me know what deals you found. All of this was on sale except for, I think, the Bobbi Brown palette and the Chanel lipstick. I think everything else was on sale and I got really, really good prices, especially with the kind of dress clothes. Those were all really, really cheap. And I'm pretty sure like these pajamas from Old Navy, I think originally these are like $16 a piece, I think, for the top and the bottom. And I think I got each one for $7. And then there was taken additional 40% off my order, I think, or something like that. I mean, like crazy cheap. So yeah. Love all the stuff that I got. Let me know what all you all got and if you got any of these things too. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. And, oh yeah, by the way, if you like spending time with me, honey, then you need to watch me on Vlogmas because I am doing Vlogmas. I did it last year and I am doing it again this year. So I would love to have you if you would like to watch. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Merry Christmas.